Hello friends, Medusa 2.0 is finally here. It's currently in preview mode, which means it's a beta. It's incomplete, both in terms of features and documentation. And I've spent a lot of time trying to get it to work, and it was a hassle, I must say. I finally have it running on Railway, fully configured, storefront, backend, everything connected, media storage, you name it. And even though the Medusa 2.0 is not at all finished, and missing a lot of features, I still want to share the deploy template with you now, because I've seen a lot of people in the community Discord server struggling to get it to work. And it can be really difficult resolving your issues that you might encounter when you're trying to host it, because the documentation as of right now doesn't really contain much help. Also, it's kind of scarce in the community who can help you. A lot of people, there's just not enough information right now. So I have compiled a deploy template where everything just works out of the box. And you can find it on my blog post right here. I will leave a link to the blog post in the video description. And the blog post talks a little bit about what to expect of Medusa 2.0. And it's basically just saying that it's incomplete and don't expect too much. A lot of features are still missing. Same for documentation. And a little bit about the template itself. So this time around, there is absolutely no configuration needed. You just click deploy and it will deploy. So I have added an internal media storage this time. If you tried my Medusa 1.0 deploy template, in that one we use Cloudinary for media storage. So you had to sign up with Cloudinary and provide API keys. And it is not difficult, but a little bit of a hassle. You don't have to do that now. It's even easier. The medias will simply just be saved on the Railway server. Another thing I added is health checks. So there is now in the storefront and the backend a route, and the route will be pinged by the Railway build runner. So whenever these two routes respond with a status 200, Railway knows that the build is live and it will give you a green check mark. Before that, in my previous deploy template, then Railway would say it was completed, but then you click on the link to access your dashboard or your storefront, and then it would say nothing is here, and that would it would take like a minute more or so before the app was actually running. But that's not the case anymore. Green checkmark now means that your app is running. Another feature I added is the automatic admin user creation. So the first time you deploy the template, admin user will be created. You can change the email of the admin user. I will show you how, but and you can also set a password, but a unique random password is set by default. So you don't, this will be completely unique for you. You don't have to worry about other people having the same password and potentially be able to reuse that to access your dashboard. It is a strong, unique password. Another key features, I have pre-installed Stripe payment plugin. But if you want to get that to run, you need to add API keys. And I currently don't have any guide on how you can do that. I might update this blog post to include that later. The same go for emailing. I have a pre-installed SendGrid email plugin and tested that it works. So I send a trial email. And again, here you need to provide API keys from your SendGrid account. And I also don't have any information on how to do that yet. So I want to give a small disclaimer about the template. This time I've added a little piece of analytics, which means that anyone who uses the template, I will get notified that someone used it. I need to know that to simply see user engagement, how many people are using it, and the number I get from Railway is incorrect. So that's why I added a little piece of analytic code to get notified when someone uses the template. And I allow you to turn it off if you don't want to notify me when you use the template. You can delete the environment variable called template reporter URL from the backend instance. If you delete this before you deploy, I will not get a ping about someone used my template. So if you want to remain completely private, you can still do so. I also encourage you to read this little disclaimer. Here's a little story of why I added it. There's a good explanation behind it. But anyway, let's get started with the deploy. I'll click the button deploy on Railway and we will be taken to the deploy page. Here you see a breakdown of what the service includes. There's a backend and a storefront. And you see here is a little disk drive saying static. And this is instead of the Railway, the Cloudinary integration last time. We now have an internal media storage on the backend that saves your media. So you don't have to worry about the media disappearing on redeploys. They will be kept safe. Let's click deploy now. And I will show you how you remove the analytics code. So if you open the backend configuration, the environment variables, scroll down a little bit, and you will see here is the template reporter URL is the only one that doesn't have a red star, so it's not required. You can remove this, and then I will not be notified that you used it. But I encourage you to leave it on. I would really appreciate it so I can see how many people actually uses the template. Here is the password. So if you want to set a password, a private password for your admin user, you can change this to a password. And here the admin email, you can change this to another email. And this only works the first time the deploy template is used, because we only see the database once. So if you want to change it later, this is not where you change it. You can't just change the email in the variables and then redeploy. It will not change your admin user. I will leave it as is for now and just deploy the template without doing anything. Just click deploy. Give it a refresh. And the canvas is now populated. Unfortunately, it didn't arrange the services as I'd like. It should be like this. And we see the backend is building and the storefront is building. I'll pause the video and be back as soon as they're ready. Okay, that didn't take long, about 4 minutes. Let's go to the backend and let's open the dashboard. I click on my URL right here. And we'll get the error page, because we need to add the, is it app/app, I believe. Yeah. And we are now loading the Medusa 2.0 admin dashboard. I'll put this view to the side. This one over here. Go to variables and I will find the Medusa admin email. I'll copy it. Paste it here. And the password, copy it, paste it here. Click continue. I don't want to save it. Now I can full screen. And yeah, here it is. It's your Medusa 2.0 dashboard. You're logged in as an admin user. I will go to products and let's just change one of them to see that we have a full connection all the way around to the storefront. So Medusa t-shirt, it's now Medusa 2.0 t-shirt. And let's give it a little emoji as well. So like that, and I save it. Yeah, the t-shirt is now saved. I will close, no, I'll just minimize my admin dashboard and let's go back and find the storefront and go to the deployment. And here's the URL, I'll click it. And we get the storefront. Well done, you have successfully deployed your Medusa 2.0 store on Railway. And here's a link back to the blog post, because I'll be adding in more information down the road with how to do stuff. So let's check if our product was updated. I'll go to the store and yeah, here it is, the Medusa 2.0 t-shirt. So it is all working. So that is all good. You now have a live Medusa 2.0 webshop, but you don't want it to look like that. You don't want it to say Medusa store here. And you also want to remove the welcome text that I created here. So let me just show you how you get this project down on your local machine to make changes to it, and then how to deploy it again. So your changes will become live on Railway. So you need to first go to one of the services that has a GitHub icon and then locate the source repo. And you see the source repo is pointing to rpulse, this is my GitHub user, and then the boilerplate repository. And you need a clone of that so you can make changes, because you can't push any changes to the boilerplate. So what you need to do is click eject and choose your GitHub user. If your GitHub user is not listed here, that's because your Railway account is not connected to your GitHub account. And I don't know exactly how to do that if you didn't sign up with GitHub, but there should be a way to connect it afterwards. And you need to have connected your GitHub account. So make sure you have your GitHub account here, and then you eject the service. This takes a little while. Okay, so it is now done, and you see your source repo is now, well, it would be your GitHub account name here, but I cloned it into my own one, so it's still my account name. And then it has the same name, boilerplate, and then a little extra something. And we can now click it here. And you see this is now a new, a clone of the boilerplate template. So this one you can actually make changes to. Let's clone it. Copy the URL. Open a terminal. Go to documents and git clone. Paste it in. And the folder name will be Medusa 2.0 demo. Into the directory Medusa 2.0 demo, and I will open it with VS Code. All right, so we now have it locally, all the files. You can see the backend and the storefront. I opened a PowerShell, but I would actually like a Git Bash terminal here. So I'll close this one. And let's just make a change. So what I always do when I make changes to projects that I'm not too familiar with, I will inspect the web page and I'll find some of the text. I'll copy it and I'll search for it. And here it is. So I now located the text I want to change, and good, save the change. And before I push this, I will just give you a brief tour of the backend. So we expand the backend, and inside packets.json, you will see that I have pre-installed the payment stripe, and there should be a send grid as well. There it is. Yeah, notification send grid, and they have been configured in the Medusa.js config. So here is the stripe. If you wanna give it a try and hook it up with API keys, this is the what you need to write: stripe API key and stripe webhook secret. And then it will show on the deploy log that it was configured and it should work. The same goes for the send grid. And if you don't want these two plugins, but you want something else, maybe you want manual payment or another payment service like PayPal or whatever, and you don't want to use SendGrid email, you can leave this here, or you can simply remove it and delete the dependencies from package log, from the package JSON, and then install your dependencies again. But let's not do that. I want to keep it around. Instead, I just want to deploy the text change I made here to my storefront. So let's see, git status. Yeah, it found a change. I'll add it. And I will commit it. Text update. And push. The push is now sent. Let's head back to, well, we can check out GitHub first. I'll just refresh and see that the storefront now has a text update, and go back to Railway. And you'll see that both the storefront and the backend is building. And that's because it is a mono repository, meaning that both the storefront and the backend is in one repository. You don't have to manage two different GitHub repositories. It is connected in one. And I'll pause the video and come back when it's done. Whoa, that was really quick. It took 2 minutes, and we now have deployed our text update. Let's verify that it actually changed. So I'll open the storefront again. And you see it now says, this is my personal Medusa 2.0 webshop. Yay, just like I wrote in VS Code. So I hope this gives you a solid foundation on to host your Medusa 2.0 project and how to make changes and, yeah, create products. If you create something awesome with this template, please leave a link to your webshop in my YouTube comment section. If you allow me, I'll feature it on my blog. So in this blog post, I am planning on writing a section down here created with this template, and then I'll link everyone's webshop who created with this template and wanted me to share it here. Okay, that is all for now. Comments and questions, you can drop it down below. Have a great day!